Hello, everybody. Jason up New Age Revolution Cave. Pretzel. Happy Halloween Eve. Wednesday. Did a little live video today showing off a couple of 2003 Nickelodeon Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle figure re-releases that I got for $10 each at Walmart, and I'm excited about the new outlook on toys that I now have. We'll see where that goes. This weekend we're going to be making some room in here. Yes, again, folks. We're gonna move that Trinitron up into the garage, accompanied by the Sega and the Super Nintendo, and that's gonna clear up a little wall space. And we need a little wall space. Because you could tell by the thumbnail, the iconic images, the visually iconic images of our childhood, folks. The He-Man logo. Yes, the He-Man logo. That was one of probably the top three boy cartoons, right? Top three. You were going to school, you were going to third grade, you and your friends were going to talk about, forget Hulk Hogan's Rock and Wrestling, forget Pound Puppies and Scooby-Doo, forget all the cartoons that they threw in here and there, even the good ones, Flintstones, forget about all that. You and your friends were either talking about G.I. Joe, Transformers, or He-Man. Those are the big three. Those are the big three. Now, I'm doing the show for this particular episode for a couple of reasons. It is not my knowledge of this visually iconic image of our childhoods. No, it's not. I am not the biggest He-Man fan. I am not an expert on the show or the cartoon. I watched it and I have some fun, brief memories of watching it. Now, my brain says I never watched it on Saturdays, ever. My brain says I never watched it on Saturdays. My brain says vaguely that I never watched it weekdays. Okay, I say that vaguely because I might have. I know for sure I didn't watch it on Saturdays. I know kind of, maybe, that I didn't watch it during the weekday. I know 100% that I watched it before school on weekday mornings, very early on my Fox station, WUHF in Rochester, because it followed or preceded, I'm not sure, G.I. Joe. But I remember watching He-Man before school on my little 13-inch color TV, right next to my bed. The TV was right next to my bed, and I would just turn it, and I would lay on my side, and I would watch G.I. Joe and He-Man before I had to go to school or before I had to get up. That memory I have. We've talked about this before. Toys of childhood did not stand a chance being a major part of my life because I was so addicted to the LJN wrestling figures and any wrestling figure. We can't just say LJNs because it was Remco's. It was LJNs and Remco's and Bendy's at the times. But I couldn't give love to any other toy line. But I would sample each toy line, and I would sample the cartoons, and I would enjoy the toys when I would go visit friends. So I watched He-Man. I don't know if I paid attention. I don't know if I cared, maybe. Same thing with G.I. Joe as a kid. I watched it. Did I pay attention? I don't know. I had a few He-Man figures as a kid. I know I had Castle Grayskull as a kid because I remember my dad and I putting it together and the elevator gave us fits, or gave me fits as a kid. You always needed a parent. I don't want to just call dads. Maybe some of us didn't have dads, but you needed a parent to do these things, especially for me, the stickers, because nothing ruins a toy so fast than a kid putting on the stickers, because he's just stupid and you destroy it. And they're wrinkly and they're crooked. But dads could put them on perfectly. So I remember my dad putting the stickers on Castle Grayskull. That's how I know I had it. I didn't have Snake Mountain. And I really can't tell you who I had for He-Man characters except for Ram Man. I know 100% in childhood I had Ram Man. And I watched the cartoon as an adult. In fact, that was one of the first, if not the first, DVD cartoon box set that I bought and watched. So that was about, I don't even think Liam was born. Maybe Liam was born. He was probably one or two. So that was about 10 years ago that I watched He-Man. And it will get a second watch sooner than later. So I don't have a ton of memories or a ton of love for He-Man. I, at one point, did collect them in the very early stages of this room. I collected many, many, many He-Men, complete, had a checklist, would highlight them on eBay. I would find them. And then it got tough. It got tough in like the last two series where prices were high and I had lost my... I know when I'm going to lose interest in something is when I just buy the figures in any condition without weapons. In the beginning of the He-Man line, I had to have them perfect. The legs had to be tight. The weapons had to be all there, and I would display them on the shelf. Towards the end, I'm just grabbing figures. King Randor, don't care. Doesn't have his weapon, whatever. It doesn't matter. And then you get into like Rakan and Stonedor or Stonedar, and I stopped. I stopped caring. I sold them all. Well, that's gross. I think I just pulled a piece of broccoli out of my teeth. If you slow it down, you might be able to see it. Now, it sounds like I'm just dissing He-Man, but I'm not. I am not. In fact, I am here to announce, as I announced today, that we would be collecting newer re-releases of older stuff for the garage. I am now here to say that I will be collecting He-Man figures with an asterisk. They will be the 1982 figures. In fact, they will be the first series only. So I am now going to begin collecting He-Man Masters of the Universe Series 1. There are 8 figures. There are, was Snake Mountain a part of it? There's at least Castle Grayskull. I don't think Snake Mountain was 82. I could be wrong. So there's at least one castle. And there are 2 vehicles from 1982. There's also Wonder Bread He-Man. That's not going to happen. That's not going to happen. Off the top of my head, it's He-Man, Skeletor, Merman, Teela, Man-at-Arms, Beastman. That's 6. There's the Eagle. What is his name? Falcor? That's not it. Yeah, I'm a huge fan. There's 8. We're going to get them all. We're going to get them all. Now, my friend Colin from Canada said, oh, you're going to be collecting He-Man? I found these, and it's all 8 from Series 1. So, apparently, those are mine. Some of them have some accessories, some don't. So we will still be hunting to complete all of those figures. I don't know how to change a leg band on He-Man. I do on G.I. Joe, but we'll learn. If the legs are loose and they won't stand up on their own, I will replace the bands. And we will be on the hunt for a complete Castle Grayskull. I'm going to go ahead and grab Snake Mountain, even if it wasn't in 82, and the two vehicles. Every once in a while, since I started thinking about this, I was looking on eBay, I was looking at Castle Grayskulls. We're probably going to spend over $100 on a complete one. That's fine. But then I start to see the boxed Castle Grayskulls. And we know how beautiful the He-Man boxes are. I'm not saying no. Not saying yes. One I saw today was like $450. Don't know if we need that. More than likely, we'll get everything loose, mint, complete. Then we're going to stop there. I'm going to stop there. I might get Ram Man. But we're going to stop there. I don't need to go on. I don't have a passion for the line, but I have a passion for collecting. And I have a passion for those images, those visually iconic images of childhood. And the He-Man figures are one of them. And so we're going to stop at series one. I think that's going to excite one of the Campbell brothers at least, which is good. So we're going to do that. It's not going to expand into board games and none of that. Eight figures, two castles, two vehicles. Done. Well, what's the thing that sits on top of the castle? Isn't that, that's not Wind Raider, that's the vehicle. There's that thing that sits on top of the castle with the bird. I think I got, if that's part of it, fine, okay. But, so there you go. So we're gonna be collecting components of a very visually iconic image from childhood, He-Man, Masters of the Universe. So stay tuned for that. I think I'm gonna get the figures from Colin around Christmas time. But don't worry, that won't stop us from beginning. So maybe in the next couple of weeks, we'll pick off one of the vehicles. We'll fully display it or fully unbox it and show it off to you guys. And I'm excited because I'm going to make some room and we'll have the collection right here. And it'll be visually iconic. I've got other ideas for the toy collection upstairs in the garage. The garage gets very dusty. And I am going to be eventually bringing figures to the garage. Once I run out of room down here, which probably after the He-Mans, we're getting close to full capacity, I'm going to get a couple of those glass display cabinets that we see in other toy collections. And I'm going to display figures behind glass. Now that opens the door for other fun figures to add to the collection. Thundercats. I might just get good guy and I might just get main bad guy. I might get a vehicle to go with the two figures. I'm not sure. I might get them in the mail and love them and want to grab more. But what I'm not going to do is spend ridiculous amounts of money on rare figures that when they come, I'll just have them and they'll just sit in the shelf when they're not, it's not a passion. I have the passion for the line, or I have the passion for the era. I have the passion for the look. I don't have a passion for the whole line. I wouldn't even know the names of any other Thundercats people except Mumra and Lion-O. That's it. Maybe Tigress. And again, but that opens the door for more stuff. Now here's the best part. You recall a while back, I sold my Chuck Norris figures. And I wouldn't say I regretted it at all. But then I've been watching these toy collection videos on YouTube, and that's what's gotten the juices flowing. I mean, there are some ridiculously amazing collection rooms out there. And in fact, I just watched one guy the other day who has a whole house. I mean, I don't know how much room this guy has, but his G.I. Joe collection, he turned into a G.I. Joe universe. So he's got one whole room dedicated to G.I. Joe. And he's got painting on the wall of jungle scenes. And he's got winter scenes. And he's got the flying vehicles hanging from the ceiling. And he's got bases everywhere. And, you know, armies of Cobra soldiers and things like that. It's just amazing. Then he did the He-Man room. And he painted the walls like Castle Grayskull. And he actually put a drawbridge door going into that room. And I just thought, that is amazing. Well, as he's touring around his room, he's got a little side collection of little things, A-Team figures that I have. And then he had his Chuck Norris figures. And I looked at him and I was like, I had those once. I sold them all for like $65, I think, or something like that. Because I didn't have the room. And everybody told me, just pack them up. Pack them up and put them away, you fool. And I said, don't tell me what to do. And I sold them. Well, guess what I should have done? I should have packed them up and put them away. Or did I? No, I didn't. But I packed up Liam's and I put Liam's away in the crawl space. And I was under there the other day looking for his packed away Funko Pops and I found a big bag of Chuck Norris figures. That's right. So I've got all my Chuck Norris figures back and the car. Yeah. So when we get the glass case in the garage, the Chuck Norris figures are going to get lined up in there. Grab a few weapons that I don't have, put the car in there, close it up, never touch it again. There it is. There's my Chuck Norris figures are back in the collection. Great. So I have to have this because I miss collecting. And like I said earlier today, I think I wasted a lot of time dissing the re-release figures. I probably should have gotten the four Ghostbusters when they re-released them from the 89 or so series when they re-released them. But I said, look at this. They can't come up with anything else. I'm not getting these. I should have. Because now they're $30-$40 a piece on eBay. Anyway, I will continue to go to the Ollie's. I will continue to go to the Big Lots and the Walmarts and the Targets and see what catches my eye. And if I get them, you know, if I buy some stuff, I'll put them out in the garage. Colin from Canada, during our Christmas gift when he brought me all that stuff, brought me four almost NECA style Ghostbusters. I forget who makes them. I think it's Mattel or Hasbro, but they're very nice. They're carded. The four Ghostbusters are like 6-inch figures. Very nice, very detailed, all in package, all carded. And I kept them in my office. Well, now I brought them home and they're going up on the wall in the garage. So that's pretty cool. So I've got two of the four Turtles from 2003 and I've got four Ghostbusters and I'm going to go get the other two Turtles tomorrow, realistically. I mean, come on, who are we fooling? And that's only Walmart. I got to hit up Target. I gotta go to Ollie's. So there's the big news. Masters of the Universe Series 1. Complete. Castles, vehicles, accessories. With a whole heck of a lot of help from Colin from Canada. But we're going to get on that. Next couple weeks we'll have our first purchase and our first unveiling. Don't know what it'll be. Might get a cheap deal on the castle. I don't know. All right, that's all. Friday night live show, guaranteed. If the kids go to my dad's, I think they are. Friday night live show. Good 2-hour show together. See you then. Good night now.